Agrippina the Younger is undoubtedly one of the most influential women in all of ancient Rome, and due to the action she took to allow this possibility, she was the most powerful and prominent woman during her marriage to Claudius and her joint leadership with Nero at the beginning of his reign. However, due to the fragmented relationship she had between her and Nero at the end of her life, we cannot be certain as to the true level of her power, betrayal, and her overall personality during her life, leaving our only understanding to information provided in sources. The greatest legacy apparent to Agrippina's life, according to the sources, appears to be a constant drive to increase her power and, as a result, influence and wealth. Tacitus's account of Agrippina's involvement with Claudius's rule indicates numerous features about her personality and actions that contribute to her legacy, including the nation moving at the fiat of a woman but not as a toy, and it being a tight-drawn, almost masculine tyranny, with austerity and arrogance and no trace of unchastity unless it might contribute to power. This description shows that Agrippina was acting in a manner to be respected on the same level as her male counterparts, demonstrating a clear strategic mind and purpose for her actions. Additionally, the mention of her passion of gold creating a bulwark of despotism shows that Agrippina took these actions to further improve her own security, and quite likely Nero's too. However, these views come at the bias of Tacitus, who saw Agrippina's empowering actions as negative, and thus attempted to portray her accordingly, which, in relation to his description of her ruling, actually favours her, portraying her as very strategic and deliberate in her actions, with her only fault in acting unwomanly. Additionally, Tacitus wrote his Annals many years after Agrippina's death, with himself not encountering her during their 3 shared years of life, meaning that he saw some from possibly biased eyewitness accounts, and any remaining evidence of her life after Nero's attempts to destroy her reputation and kill her, and his own interpretation of history. This, however, does not negate the usefulness of the source, as aspects such as Agrippina's intense involvement in Claudius's reign can be validated by other sources, and this provides a very detailed and insightful account of public perception to Agrippina's involvement during Claudius's reign, allowing for a legacy during this time to be revealed. Due to Tacitus's accounts of Agrippina, it is revealed that due to her involvement and actions taken during the reign of Claudius, while she ended up a very powerful and prominent individual, the public was not entirely in her favour, as her masculine tyranny opposed their view on female representation and involvement in the political sphere. Grund finds himself exploring an opposing legacy of Agrippina in relation to her depictions on coins and statues as matron and priestess, emblematic of domestic rectitude and public piety, and a central figure of the dynasty. This notion serves to undercut the reliability of written sources such as Tacitus and provide more motive to Agrippina's action, and additional perception from the noble and senatorial class of Rome who allowed these visual depictions into public presence. While it remains present that Agrippina was a highly powerful and influential individual, such as her depictions alongside emperors on coins, the negative aspects of this provided by Tacitus are countered, and a greater positive position is highlighted. Such imagery that provides more positive perception of Agrippina include her representation as securitas on coinage during Caligula's reign, showing she is to be trusted and offers security to the nation, and wearing a corn ear crown on coins during Claudius's reign, linking her to ideas of prosperity and fertility. Although this imagery was made in high, often over-exaggerated levels of bias towards Agrippina, as it was often her own input to how she wanted to be perceived, it provides great usefulness to those studying Agrippina, and allows a greater understanding of her legacy to evolve. Not a power-hungry woman attempting to control Rome, but a woman whose relationships with the emperors allowed for great opportunities to increase her wealth, influence, and power, and who has to take measures to improve the public view of her due to her frequent anti-stereotype public and private displays. However, it is very important to remember that these visual sources don't depict her exactly as she was, and only act to improve her image, limiting the potential for a precise understanding of her character to be gathered. Agrippina the Younger was the most significant female in ancient Rome during the later years of her life, by being Caligula's brother, Claudius's husband, and Nero's mother. Agrippina was able to wedge her way into the ruling position of the Julio-Claudian dynasty to aim it towards the future she hoped for. While she will be remembered as a power-hungry, tyrannical ruler due to the numerous written male sources, a picture of Agrippina and the somewhat positive impact she left on ancient Rome can only be explored if an understanding of her positive portrayals in visual sources are taken into account. Agrippina was an opportunist who strived away to success partially through manipulation, but a controlling hand over the Roman Empire allowed for a clear goal in the emperors she influenced to achieve, and possibly a reduction in total damage that could have incurred if she had not been present, such as Nero's insanity and destruction of Rome after her death. Thanks. In a little cafe.